sports. It's in the game.
To me, it's all about Tom Brady. He's just one of those guys that if the game is on the line, you need a big play, he'll make that play for you.
Reload! Check it! 220! Why can we check?
When Latifah ready, when we set it off, we set it off. If they sleeping on me, I'ma wake them up. They fake as I got real, I really do. I'm kicking up the rent is due. Plus I got my mama and my kiddies too, they growing up. Time is moving faster, what we wasting for, no holding back. Got a lot to prove I owe you that we all we got. I go out for my squad and I put that on God.
Squad.
All I got is my word. Get you different when you moving far. But just stick to the code, you get yours, I get mine.
I've
been reflecting on how we got this far, even when the pressure's on, finessing strong. Plus I got my team around me, heavy, ain't no extra bros. You can keep them, keep Giuseppe's on delusion. No, who gon' be there for you if you lose it all? Question that, who gon' have your mama back, your mama back? So much more than life, take advantage. We gon' get this money, stack this paper, and be
on. Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome.
Right at the convergence of the Three Rivers on Art Rooney Drive, we welcome you to Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the New Orleans Saints and the Pittsburgh Steelers. And there's Ben Roethlisberger ready to lead out the Pittsburgh Steelers offense. And he put the retirement talk on the back burner. And he said, I am coming back next season. We'll see. He'll be 36 when next year starts.
But I think he's having too much fun, actually, to retire and has some unfinished business. This team is good enough to get to and win a Super Bowl. They didn't accomplish that in 2017, despite having the most prolific offense in the NFL. And Ben's numbers are terrific as well. 4,200 yards, 28 touchdowns last season.
On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. Flush to his right. And some space here. And they're able to get this one across the 35. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards. Big Ben, not the most agile quarterback in NFL history. But he can use those legs when he needs to.
He really can, and I think it starts with him taking contact and shedding people trying to get him on the ground. That's when he becomes the most elusive.
Yeah, something he honed back at the University of Miami in Ohio.
Yeah, and they didn't get him down in the MAC. It's hard to get him down in the NFL.
It's complete to Brown, right side. It'll be a gain of 17 at a Pittsburgh first.
like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
So here we go, first and 10 now. Now it's Roethlisberger, escaping the pressure right. Got a man, it's Brown. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Probably mean to jump in on you, partner, but they didn't waste any time getting downfield, did they? I mean, a nice big play there.
Three successful plays in plus territory. Now this defense on its heels a bit.
It seems like they had something targeted there, doesn't it? It's like, okay, we've got a matchup we like coming right out of the gate. Let's go ahead and get right to it.
And he doesn't quite make it. They do stop him, but he gets it all the way down to the one.
I know from past experience, before you actually play a game, you visualize what's going to happen. And I don't know anyone who doesn't visualize themselves being in the center of what's going on. That's three catches for him here in the early going. He's got to like the way this is starting.
Absolutely. Three catches on any drive is good. Opening drive, that's a tone setter. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. To throw again is Roethlisberger. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. A.J. Klein coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7.
Well, surprise, surprise. First and goal at the 1. No quarterback sneak. No running play. They decide to throw for it, but the pressure got to him quickly and put the quarterback down.
And this will be incomplete. Can this defense get the stop on the opening drive? Here's third and goal. Now it's Roethlisberger, eluding the pressure right. Got his man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Antonio Brown from 8 yards. Take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Chris Boswell now for the extra point. Throwing Jones. I thought the days of the fake extra point were numbered once they moved these kicks back to the 15. Apparently I was mistaken.
Yeah, I was wondering who was ever going to try to do this. In fact, I couldn't wonder. I didn't think it would ever happen, taking a fake from the 15-yard line to try and pick up an extra point. I didn't think anyone would ever call this.
Short kick. One of the up middle take it now. Drew Brees ready to bring out the New Orleans offense. And for Brees, his streak of 3 straight passing titles came to an end this season. He finished 2nd, but still, he went over 70,000 passing yards for his career.
And I don't think he was unhappy about that streak coming to an end, because that meant the running game had gotten back into vogue for him. And Mark Ingram, Alvin Kamara, they really had big years, allowed him to be way more comfortable throwing the football. He did have his 12th straight year over 4,000 yards, though, with 4,334. So all was not lost for Drew Brees.
He is a free agent. Saints could use the franchise tag on him. And he says he wants to be a Saint for the remainder of his career.
And if that organization is listening to that, make him a Saint for the rest of his career. It makes your team that much better.
On 2nd down, here's Brees. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. The tight end Josh Hill was the target, and now it's 3rd down. And a very good offensive unit here. One of the reasons they're so good is running back Mark Ingram.
Took a little while for him to find his footing when he got into the league, but the former Heisman Trophy winner has it now and has really upped respect his pass receiving potential. A nice player.
And with a third and 13 here, the defense in a dime look. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. And is Steeler pressured too much here? He's going down. T.J. Watt coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it'll be fourth down. We say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offense.
Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on fourth down. Back deep for the Steelers, Antonio Brown. A good return there, 17 yards. Want to give a hat tip real quick, Charles, to J.J. Watt before the possession switches here. Walter Payton, NFL Man of the Year. They totaled up how much he helped raise for hurricane relief, $37 million.
Incredible. Hurricane Harvey, which really hit the Houston area in a big way, and his original goal was $200,000. So congratulations to J.J. Watt and all the people who participated. And Greg Olsen of the Panthers, Benjamin Watson of the Ravens, both tight ends, also nominated and finalists for the most prestigious award as determined by the NFL, the Walter Payton Man of the Year Award.
Second and 10 now, it's Roethlisberger. Flushed out right. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass on the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt... performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. Defensively, they're going to have to do something about him in a hurry because that last catch puts him over the 100-yard mark. We haven't even hit the second quarter yet.
And you did say they'd have to do it in a hurry. It has to be right now because as his confidence grows, it'll actually overwhelm the defense. No matter what they do, they feel like they can't stop him.
A good pick up there, 26 yards. Charles, you think Big Ben is happy to have Antonio Brown on the other side of his passes?
You know he is, but he also expects it. And this is how their offense runs best. When those two get together, especially early, and continue to do it throughout the game.
And they're going to get to him, a sack. Sacked back at the 9-yard line. A.J. Klein in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon.
Well, that was point counterpoint, wasn't it? They decide to throw for it on first and goal. Instead, the defense counters with pressure, and the defense wins, getting a big sack.
Here's Roethlisberger, flush to his right. And caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Le'Veon Bell, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead. And that was really just a great battle for that football on both sides. The result is a touchdown.
Ordinarily, I'd like to say it was a win-win,
but it really wasn't because the defender, while he was there with excellent coverage, he didn't get the benefit, did he?
But he's not going to get chewed up in film session, will
he? No, he was right there. They'll tell him, okay, of course you need to knock the ball away, but they won't be too upset with him. He did his job for the most part. Okay, they went for the fake off of the extra point attempt. It's a long way to go, and they didn't get there, didn't get it completed successfully. Did someone dare them to do that? Did someone double dog dare him to do that?
I was going to ask you, maybe they saw something on film, but do you see something on film with those to try something from the 15 on a PAT? I don't know.
The only thing they needed to see on film there was a snap, a hold, and someone kicking the ball through the post.
Before the possession switches here, I had written down that I wanted to talk about some of the awards this past season in the NFL. We know Brady was the MVP, but Todd Gurley, Offensive Player of the Year.
How about that for a bounce back? Many were questioning whether he'd had a sophomore slump the season before. Didn't even get to 1,000 yards. Was a dominant force in 2017. How about his teammate Aaron Donald on the defensive side? He took home Defensive Player of the Year award.
Yeah, very impressive. They had both sides of the ball. Sean McVay deserving, I think you would agree, of Coach of the Year.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, what he did for the Rams when they went from last in the league in scoring to leading the league in scoring and winning a division title. And how about the New Orleans Saints? Rookie of the Year, offense and defense. Alvin Kamara on offense, Marshawn Lattimore on defense.
Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 23 yards on the play. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Saints football to begin quarter number two. And they've got it here with a first down. From the gun, it's Breeze. He gets it to Thomas. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
They go play action here on first down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And they'll get to him just inside the 15. Even after the strong run we just saw, they're able to corral him quickly defensively.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense, because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
On second down, Ingram. And this play goes nowhere, losing yardage back to the 15. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to say?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. From the gun on third down, Breeze. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. On fourth down, off goes Drew Brees, and on comes the Saints kicker, Will Lutz, for the field goal attempt. And Lutz puts this one through. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in three. So they were able to move the ball into the red zone, but they'll wind up coming away with just three.
Yeah, 32-yarder. That's equal to an extra point nowadays, and those are no problem for an NFL kicker.
Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This fielded at the two. Dances by him. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. CD, I want to get your thoughts on some potential free agents this offseason before we change the possession here. Now, caution, many of these guys could be resigned, I know, but who are some of them? Kirk Cousins is one.
Yeah, we're talking about difference makers. Kirk Cousins at the quarterback position, he's going to be coveted around the league for by quarterback needy teams. Case Keenum had a big year. Could he move? But how about running backs? Le'Veon Bell, Deion Lewis, some pass catchers.